गुड मॉर्निंग टू एवरीवन, आई एम गौरव गुप्ता, एसयूएल मैथमेटिक्स टीचर। टुडे दिस इज आवर फिफ्थ लेक्चर ऑन क्लास 10th चैप्टर 2 पॉलीनोमियल। आई रिक्वेस्ट दोज स्टूडेंट्स हु स्टिल नॉट वॉच माय प्रीवियस 4 वीडियो, बिकॉज इन आवर फर्स्ट 4 वीडियो वी ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड मेनी कॉन्सेप्ट्स एंड ऑलमोस्ट वी डिड कंप्लीट द होल चैप्टर ऑफ 2। Today this is our fifth lecture, and in this lecture we are going to take each and every question of your exercise 2.3 from your NCERT. If you are reading some other books like R.D. Sharma, R.S. Agarwal and so other books and try to solve some typical question, if you have any problem, so you can comment me on my YouTube channel, then I will make a separate video by taking your each and every question as my level best. So don't worry, I am trying to take your every problem. As due to spreading of coronavirus throughout the world, so everyone stayed at their home. So I request everyone, please stay at your home and be safe. But in this duration, we have to do study also, because we cannot stop our study. So I try to make all the videos with each and every example with exercise of class 8 to class 12. So please share this video among to your friends, among to your neighbors, so those which want to really study, they can watch me and study at their home, because you have to stay at your home and be safe. So I'm not waste your time, and again I request, if you have still problem, and you can take a screenshot of that problem, or you can take a pic of that question and do WhatsApp me on my WhatsApp number. Please note my WhatsApp number is 9671632413. I will try to make the solution of your problem as possible. So don't forget to send your problem on this my number, and my YouTube channel is Gaurav Gupta Maths Classes. So don't forget to subscribe my channel and press the button icon button of bell, so you can get automatically notification whenever I upload a new video. So don't worry, we will study at home also. So our first topic is, or your first question is, we have to divide the polynomial p of x, divide the polynomial by g of x. What is p of x notation and what is g of x notation? You have to come on our topic, Euclid algorithm. We already did Euclid algorithm, lemma methods. In this case, we got a relation p of x is equal to g of x into q of x plus r of x. What is this? P of x is nothing, this is your dividend, which we have to divide. G of x is your divisor, that we have to divide it. Q of x is your quotient and R of x is your remainder polynomial. So how we get this relation? Please make a look. If I have a number 7 and I am going to divide by 2, 2 3 is 6, I got 1. It means 7 is your dividend, this is your 7, which is equal to g of x. G of x is divisor, here divisor is 2, multiply quotient, here quotient is 3, plus remainder, remainder is your 1. So this is the method to represent our dividend in terms of your quotient, divisor and remainder terms. So please make a note first. And the next important condition is, the remainder polynomial should be greater than or equal to 0 but less than the remainder polynomial. Please make a look first. Here the divisor is 2 and the remainder is 1. It means 2 is less than 1. This statement is true. Now take another one example. But we have take divisor as a 2. I am going to take an example 2 divide by 8. We have to divide 2, 8 by 2. 2 fours are 8. We get quotient is 2 but the divisor is 2. Now compare What's the remainder is 0 again. Sorry, I'm writing here 2 is greater than 1, because I'm writing this also in terms of 1 is less than 2. 2 is your divisor and 1 is your remainder. Now same case here, divisor is 2, which is greater than, remainder is 0. So g of x is greater than 0, and 0 is what is your r of x. So it will satisfy the condition, r of x should be greater than or equal to 0 but less than the divisor polynomial. Both the cases divisor polynomial is greater. This is the condition whenever we have to divide. So please make a note first, then we will try to solve our first question. So let me take our first question. First question is divide the polynomial. It means we have to divide the polynomial p of x. So we have to write p of x. What is p of x? Is x cube minus 3x square plus 5 into x minus 3 divide by the polynomial g of x. What is g of x? Is x square minus 2. And find the quotient. Quotient is q of x. And the remainder. Remainder is r of x. In the following case, I am taking our question number first part. So I have to tell you some points that you keep in your minds. Firstly, whenever you write your polynomial, there is no term missing. For example, here is the highest power of 3, then highest power of 2, then 1, then 0. It means there is no missing terms. If there is some missing term, firstly you have to write the missing term as a zero term, zero coefficients. But don't try to miss the term, because this way makes your calculations and answer exact, not a miss any term. So this point must be kept in your mind. Never miss the missing term to write. So what you have to divide this polynomial by this. So you have to eliminate your first term. And why we and how we remove this? We have to use divisor, and by taking assume, what we have to do, multiply with this polynomial, and we get a term of x cube. And which number we have to multiply by this number, so that we get a result of x cube. You have to take only your first term. So and if I am comparing this, if I multiply by x, we get x cube, that is your first term. So this type of step you have to think. Otherwise you can do by easily by taking another method. How the, what's the method? We have to write your first term. Our first term is here x cube. Now take the first term of divisor also. Divisor is x square. If we divide them, what we will got? We got x. Now we have to take term x, that we have to multiply by the divisor. Now multiply this. X into x square, which is equal to x cube. Now x into minus 2, we get minus 2x. So keep in mind, we have to write the coefficient in terms of same order terms, because in this we get minus 2x, it means we get the coefficient of x. So you have to write in write down the below of the coefficient of x term, where the coefficient of x is here. So we have to write this minus 2x below the this term. So we have to write here minus 2x. Are you getting my points? I hope you are understanding my concept. So next step is you have to change the step, because we are subtract this term from this term. So we have to change the sign. Here the sign is not mentioned. It means sign is positive and we are changing the sign negative. Here sign is negative. We have to change the sign. So we get positive. Now solve this. This term is positive and this term is negative. It means this term cancel out. and minus 3x square, there is no other terms, so it will be remain as it is. So we get minus 3x square. Now compare it, this is plus, this is plus, plus 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 5x plus 2x, which is equal to 7x. Now our last term is minus 3, we have to take it as it is. Now our first term is, we have to repeat the same process. Now our first term is minus 3x square, and we have to divide by the same x square. X square cancel out with x square, what we will got? Minus 3. Now we have to multiply it with minus 3. Now do multiplication, minus 3 into x square, we get minus 3x square. Minus 3 into minus 2, we get 6. It means 6 is your constant term, and we have to write below the constant term. So we have to write here 6. Now again change the sign. This is negative, we have changed positive. This is positive, we have to take sign negative. And what will be the answer? This is negative, this is positive. It means this term cancel out. This is positive, there is no other terms. So we have to write as it is. This is negative, this is negative, minus 3 and minus 6, which is equal to minus 9. So we have to write our quotient as well as remainder. What will be the quotient? Our quotient is x minus 3. And what will be the remainder? Remainder is 7x minus 9. So make a note first. Let me cover next question, second part of the question first. Now here, what is the value of p of x is this, and what's the value of g of x is this. We have to divide. Now take the same step, not miss any step. Firstly we have to write the p of x. So I am writing here p of x. Please check the terms. Here is the highest power of 4, then 3, but the term 3 is missing. So we have to take its coefficient 0, but we have to write the term must. So we have to write first x4, but the term of x3 is missing. So we write coefficient as 0 of x3. Now the power is 2 is available. So we write 3x square, then 1, which is 2, then 5. It means we write all the terms. Now look at this, x square plus 1 minus x. It means the order of the terms are changed. We have to write in order, highest power to lower power. It means we have to write in terms of decreasing order. So firstly we have to write x square, then we have to write minus x, then we have to write plus 1. So now do the same step. Our first term is x4, and this term is x square. If we divide it, we get x square. It means we have to multiply the divisor by x square. Now multiply x square into x square, we get x4. Now x square into minus x, we get minus x cube. Minus x cube. Now x square into 1, we got x square. Our next step is change the sign. This is positive, it becomes negative. This is negative, it becomes positive. This is negative. Now solve this. This is positive term, this is negative term. It means this is cancel out. This is 0, this is 1. It means we get 1. This is negative, this is negative. Negative, negative, positive, and the sign is negative. Minus 3 and minus 1 is minus 4x square. Now look at this, plus 4x as it is, plus 5 as it is. Now our first term is x cube, and divisor will be remain same. What's the result? We get x. Now we have to multiply it by x. Multiply x into x square, we get x cube. X into minus x, we get minus x square. X into 1, we get x. Now again change the sign. this is positive, we make it negative. This is negative, we make it positive. This is positive, we make it is negative. Now, this is positive, this is negative. The same term will be cancelled out. Negative positive means negative we have to subtract. This is minus 4, this is 1. We get minus 3x square because the higher term sign is negative. Now, this is positive, negative. Negative we have to subtract. 4 minus 1, 3x. And the sign of higher term is positive. So, that's why I am taking here positive. Now, we get plus. I repeat the step. First term is minus 3x square. We have to divide it by x square. So, x square cancel out. We get minus 3. It means we have to multiply it with minus 3. Now, do multiplication. Minus 3 into minus x square. Minus 3x square. Minus 3 into minus x. Plus 3x. Minus 3 into minus 1. Minus 3. Again, change the sign. This is negative, we have to make it positive. This is positive, we have to make it negative. This is negative, we have to make it positive. So, this term is negative, positive, same term. They are cancelled out. This is positive, negative, same terms. They are also cancelled out. This is positive, positive, positive. And 5 plus 3 is equal to 8. So, our quotient is x square plus x minus 3. And what's our remainder is 8. Please make a note first. So let's we take our next part, third part of the question first. Here p of x is this and g of x is this. Now do the same step. Firstly we have to write our p of x. Here again check. The highest power of this x is 4. Then it comes next power is x cube. But the term x cube is missing. So we have to take coefficient of x cube as a 0. So write in proper format. This is x4. X cube is missing. We can write as 0 x cube. X square is also missing. We write as 0 into x square. Then minus 5 into x plus 6. We write all the terms. Don't forget to write the missing term. You have to write all the terms. Now look at this. The order of the terms are interchanged. So we have to write in decreasing order. So firstly you have to write it minus x square. Then this is positive because the sign of x square is negative and the sign of 2 is positive. We are taken in decreasing order, not to change the sign of the terms. So our first term is x4. So we have to divide by first term, which is equal to minus x square. It means x square turns out to, we get minus x square. Now do multiply it with minus x square. Now minus x square into minus x square, we get positive x4. Minus x square into 2, minus 2x square. And we have to write the coefficient below the same term. So we get here minus 2x square. It means x square coefficient. So we write here minus 2x square. That term must be same. Now change the sign. This sign is positive, we have to take it negative. This sign is negative, we have to make it positive. And this is same terms and opposite side are cancelled out. This is 0, so there is no need to write further. This is 0, this is positive 2. It means we get positive 2 x square. And these terms are as it is. Minus 5x plus 6. Now our first term is 2x square. And divisor will be remain same, minus x square. Then x square will be cancelled out with x square. What we will put? Minus 2. Now we have to multiply with minus 2. 2 multiply, minus 2 into minus x square, we get plus 2x square. Minus 2 into plus 2, we get minus 4. Now this is negative and this we have to make positive. So this is cancelled out. The remaining term is minus 5x and 6 plus 4 is equal to 10. Now whenever the terms, which is in this case of x square, but in this case of x, when the remainder comes in lower form as your divisor form, so it means your division is completed. You have to not to divide to further. Again I repeat, In this, the highest power of x is 2, but in this case, highest power of is 1. It means divisor has greater degree than the remainder. Whenever you got the degree of the divisor is greater than the degree of the remainder, you have to stop the calculations because you have to done your question. So, what's the your question is? Our question is minus x square minus 2. And what's the remainder is minus 5x plus 10. This is your final answer. So please make a note first. Let me go to our next question. What's the next question is? Please make a look. What it say? It say check whether the first polynomial is a factor, and you know how we check a factor. If you someone asked you, is this term is a factor of Q? What it means? It means if we divide that term by the given terms, we get the remainder is 0. Then you can say that this is your factor, otherwise not. For example, I am saying question is 2 a factor of 12? I am asking you a question. Is 2 a factor of 12? It means if we divide 2 by 12, we get a remainder is 0, then it will be a factor, otherwise not. So 2, 12 divided by 2, 2 6 are 12, and we get remainder is 0. Answer is yes. The same we have to do here. So dividend is, we have to divide second polynomial, it means we have to divide by second by first. Second polynomial by the first polynomial, it means what is our p of x? P of x is our second polynomial, 2 raised to the power 4 plus 3 t raised to the power 3 minus 2 t raised to the power 2 minus t minus 12. This is your divisor. Oh, sorry, this is your dividend, and you have to write here divisor. What is divisor is? T square minus c. The steps are same. We have to take our first term. Our first term is 2 t raised to the power 4. 2 t raised to the power 4. And we have to divide by first term, which is equal to t square. And what we will put? T square is answer out of the t4. What we will put? 2 t square. So it means we have to multiply it by 2 t square. Now multiply it. 2 t square into t square, we get 2 t raised to the power 4. Now multiply 2 t square minus 3, what we will call minus 6 t square. So we have to write the coefficient on the same term. Now change the sign, this term is positive, we have to make it negative. This is negative, we have to make it positive. The terms are same and signs are different, so they will cancel out each other. Here is no term of t cube, so we have to write as it is to this term. We get 3t cube. This is negative, this is positive, it means we have to subtract. 6 minus 2, we get 4t square, and the sign of the higher term, which is equal to plus. Now what we will got? 9t minus 12. Now multiply it. Our first term is here 3t cube. Our first term is 3t cube, and we have to divide by the same term. What we will put? We put 3 into t. We divide because t square cancel out with t cube, and remains remainder is t. T into 3 is 3t. So we have to multiply it with 3t. Now again multiply 3t into t square. What's the result? 3t cube. 3t into minus 3, we get minus 9t. Now do the same step. Change the sign. Positive, we have to make it negative. Negative, we have to make it positive. The terms are same, signs are different. They are cancelled out. There is no term of t square, so we have to write it as it is. Negative, positive, same term, they are cancelled out. Minus 12 as it is. Now, what's the first term is 4t square. our cost term is 4t square and first term is our t square. So t square will cancel out with t, but we will got 4. It means we have to divide by 4. So multiply it 4 into t square, we get 4t square. 4 into minus 3, we get minus 12. Now change the sign. This is positive, we have to make it negative. This is negative, we have to make it positive. Now this term cancel out, we get remainder is 0. So remainder is 0. So answer is yes. This is a factor. Yes, this is a factor. That is your final answer. So make a note first. I am going to take next part, second part. The question is same. We have to divide second by first. So write 3x raised to the power 4 plus 5 into x raised to the power 3 minus 7 x raised to the power 2 plus 2 into x plus 2. Our first term is this x square plus 3x plus 1. There is no missing term. So we have to do the same steps. Our first term is here 3x raised to the power 4 and this pair first term is x square. So we get a value of 3x square. Now do multiply with 3x square. 3x square into x square, we got 3x raised to the power 4. 3x square into 3x, but we will got 9x raised to the power 3. Now multiply 3x raised to the power 1, we get plus 3x raised to the power 2. Now change the sign. All the sum signs are positive, so we have to take negative. Same terms, they are cancel out each other. Positive, negative, negative. It means 9 minus 5, which is equal to minus 4x2. Minus 7 minus 3, we get minus 10x raised to the power 2. Remaining terms we have to write as it is. First. Now what's our first term is minus 4x2. Minus 4x2, we have to divide by the same term. X term is cancelled out with, but we get 1. It means minus 4x. Now multiply with minus 4x. Minus 4x into x square, we get minus 4x cube. Minus 4x into 3x, but we got minus 12x raised to the power 2. Now to multiply minus 4x with 1, but we will got minus 4x. Now change the sign. This is negative, we have to make it positive. This is negative, we have to make it positive. This is negative, we have to make it positive. The terms are same, so they are cancelled out. This is negative and this is positive. We get positive 2x square. This is positive, positive. We get 6x plus 2. Now our first term is 2x square. Divide by the same. X square cancel out with x square, we get 2. So now we have to multiply it with by 2. 2 into x square, 2x square. 2 into 3x, we get 6x. 2 into 1, 2. Now change the sign, negative, negative, negative. So all are cancelled because all the terms are same and they have different sign. So we get remainder is 0. So answer is yes, this is a factor. So next part, third part, you have to do it yourself. I'm going to take third question. Before to take third question, please take a screenshot or make a note. So let's take our third question. Obtain all the other zeros of this polynomial. If two of its zeros are given, please look at the polynomial. The degree of the polynomial is 4. It means it has 4 zeros because the number of zeros is equal to number of the degree of the polynomial. So in this we have already given 2 zeros. Then what we have to do? we have to find out the remaining other two zero. This question is very important, and such type of question are mostly or most probably asked in your final exams. I will take another one examples also from your NCERT. Firstly, we have to do this question, and what we have to follow the steps to solve and to find out the remaining other zeros. First step is, step one is, our first zeros is, zeros means the values of x at which the polynomial becomes zero. It means these are the values of x. So our first value is x is equal to square root of 5 by 3, and second value is x is equal to negative square root of 5 by 3. If we take it to the left hand side, then what we will got? We got x minus square root of 5 by 3. And if it, we will take it on the left hand side, and what we will got? X square root of plus 5 by 3. Now we have to do second step, multiply. Multiply. For example, what I want to say? For example, 32 is our polynomial which we have to divide, and I said 2 is a factor. Means if we divide 32 by 2, we get our remainder is 0. I am again saying 4 is another factor of 32. 4 is a 32. Again, so 2 and 4 is a factor of the same polynomial, and if I multiply it, what's the result? 2 into 4. Which is equal to 8, and if we divide by 8 fourths are 32, because the remainder is 0. It means this is also a factor of the given polynomial. Same here, this is our first factor, this is our second factor. If we multiply both of them, we get another factor which is also a factor of the given polynomial. So if we multiply it, what is in the form of a minus b and a plus b? What's the identity? A minus b, a plus b, which is equal to a square minus b square. So our first term is a x, so we have to do square of x. Second term is root 5 by 3, so we have to do square, and the sign is negative. But we got x square as it is, and square root will be cancelled out with squaring. So we get only 5 by 3. So we can say x square minus 5 by 3 is also a factor of the given polynomial. Please make a note first, then you remember always why we do these steps. Please make a note first in your writing slides. So now we have to divide, because this is the factor of the given polynomial. So if we divide this term by a divisor, this term, we get a remainder 0. So do this step. Step third. Divide. Our polynomial is 3s raised to the power 4 plus 6x raised to the power 3 minus 2x raised to the power 2 minus 10 into x minus 5. And what's the factor is x square minus 5 by 3. X square minus 5 by 3. So our first term is here 3x raised to the power 4, and this here is x square. So x square will cancel out with 4, but we will got 3x square. See, x square. So our first term that we have to multiply 3x square. Now do the same rule as we already did. 3x square into x square, but we will got 3x raised to the power 4. 3x square into multiply minus 5 by 3. 3 with cancel out with 3, but we will got minus 5x square. Minus 5x square, and we have to write below the x square term. That's why I'm writing here minus 5x square. Again, 3x square into x square, we got 3x4. If we multiply this, 3 will cancel out with 3, and we get minus 5x square. So that's why I'm writing below the x square terms. Now change the sign, this term is positive, we have to make it negative. This is negative, we have to make it positive. Now our first solve this term are the same, so they are cancelled out. This term will be written as same, 6x cube negative positive, it means we get plus 3x square minus 10 into x minus 5. Now our first term is 6x cube, and divisor will be same, x square will be cancelled out 1, but we will put 6x, so do multiply with 6x. 6x into x square, we got 6x cube. Now multiply this, 3 cancel out with 6, 2's up. So we get minus 5 into 2, 10, minus 10x. So we have to write here, again, if we please make a note, minus 5 by 3, we have to multiply it with 3x. 3 2's up, 6, we get minus 5 into 2, minus 10x. So now make change the sign. Here is positive, we have to make it negative. This is negative, we have to make it positive. The same term, different sign, cancel out. We got 3x square. This same term, different sign, cancel out. We get minus 1. Now our first term is 3x square. And what we have to multiply and divide by x square? We get only 3. So it means we have to multiply it with 3. Now multiply 3 into x square, we get 3x square. Now 3 will cancel out with 3, so we get only minus 5. Yes, remainder is 0. It means our division is correct. If your remainder is not 0, it means you are doing some mistake. Again I repeat, if you got remainder is 0, then your calculation is good, correct. If you got some remainder, then you have did some wrong calculations. So make a note first. Now we get this as our quotient, and we have to make its factor that gives the other zeros. So why I am doing this? 3x square plus 6x plus 3. This is our quotient, and it gives us the remaining other two zeros. Now factorize this. What's the factor of this? 3x square, 3 is a 9. So what we have to take? 3x plus 3x plus 3. If I take 3x as a common, what we will put? X plus 1. If I take 3 as a common, I get x plus 1. Then what's the factor? 3x plus 3 and x plus 1. So 3x plus 3 is equal to 0. It means 3x is equal to minus 3, x is equal to minus 1. If I solve this, x plus 1 is equal to 0, I get minus 1. So the quotient has 4 zeros. First zero is, I am writing here, first 0 is square root 5 by 3, second 0 is minus square root of 5 by 3, third 0 is minus 1, and again fourth 0 is minus 1. This is your final answer. So please make a note, first then I will explain or take another example of similar such question. Okay, now I'm going to take another example as we already did in a question 3rd. Look at this. Find all others 0. The polynomial is 2x4 because again the polynomial is x power 4. It is in the degree of the polynomial is 4, so it has 4 zeros and we already give 2 zeros. Now the all we have to do the same step. First step is our first zeros is x is equal to root 2 and second zeros is x is equal to minus root 2 and we have to take it on our left hand side. Then what we will put x minus root 2 and this is x plus root 2. Step 2, multiply x minus root 2 and x plus root 2. This is match a minus b, a plus b, which is equal to a square minus b square. So here a is x, we get x square, b is root 2, so we get square root, and this gives us x square, and square root will be cancelled out with by squaring, so we get 2. Third step, we have to divide the polynomial by the this divisor. So this is a x square minus 2 is a factor of the given polynomial. So we have to divide. Now I am going to divide. I am taking here divide. What's the polynomial is 2x raised to the power 4 minus 3x raised to the power 3 minus 3x raised to the power 2 plus 6x minus 2. And what we have to divide from it? X square minus 2. So the same process. Our first step is here 2x raised to the power 4. And here first step is x square. We got 2x square. It means we have to divide it from 2x square. Now multiply it. 2x square into x square. We got 2x raised to the power 4. 2x square into minus 2, we got minus 4x square. So we have to write below the same term, minus 4x square. Now change the sign. This is sign, we have to make it negative. This is negative, we have to make it positive. We get same term, different signs, they are cancelled out each other. Minus 3x cube term, we have to write as it is. Negative positive, it means we get positive 1x square. Now write the remaining terms as it is. Now here we got our first term is minus 3x cube. Divide term is same. X square will be cancelled out with 1. We get minus 3x. So we get minus 3x. Now multiply this. Minus 3x into x square. We got minus 3x cube. Minus 3x into minus 2. We got plus 6x. Now change the sign. Positive, negative. They are cancelled out. Positive x square term as it is, this term cancel out, positive negative same term, different signs, and we have to write negative as it is. Now first term is x square and first term is x square, they are cancel out, we get only 1. So we have to multiply it by 1. Multiply it, 1 into x square is x square, 1 into minus 2, minus 2. The terms are same, so they are cancel out, we get the remainder is 0. It means we get remainder 0, our steps is totally correct. Now what we obtain? Our question q of x is what? 2x square minus 3x plus 1. Now factorize that. What's the factor? Multiply, we get 2 and if we add we get minus 3. And what's the factor? Minus 2x and minus x. Take it 2x as a common, we get x minus 1. Now take 1 as a common, we get x minus 1. So factor be that we got 2x minus 1 and x minus 1. And what's the value? If 2x minus 1 is equal to 0, x values is equal to 1 by 2. If x minus 1 is equal to 0, the values of x is 1. So our final answer is first root is root 2, second zeros is minus square root of, third is 1 by 2, and fourth one is 1. So this is our 4 zeros. I hope you understand this concept. So make a note first. Let us going to take another question. Question number is 4. So make a note first. On dividing this, it means we have to divide this number. So this is your polynomial p of x. So write this. Our p of x is x cube minus 3x square plus x plus 2 by a polynomial. It means this one is our divisor. G of x is our divisor. But the polynomial of divisor is not given in the question. Now read the next part. The quotient and the remainder, it means were this and this. It means this is your quotient and this one is your remainder. So please note, your quotient is q of x is x minus 2. Remainder is r of x is equal to minus 2x plus 5. And we know according to Euclid algorithm, p of x is equal to g of x into q of x plus into plus rx. So do this step and we have to calculate the values of g of x. Now put all these values. P of x is equal to g of x into q of x plus mein r of x using Euclid lemma. Now put it, p of x is x cube minus 3x square plus mein x plus mein 2, which is equal to g of x. We have to take it as it is because we have to calculate this. Q of x is x minus 2. What is r of x? Minus 2x plus 4. Now we have to calculate g of x. So that's why we have to separate them. Now I am going to take this on the left hand side. Then what we will got? X cube minus 3x square plus x plus 2. This negative becomes here positive. This positive becomes here negative, which is equal to g of x into x minus 2. So please simplify it. But we will go x cube minus 3x square. Now this x and 2x, which is equal to 3x. 2 minus 4, which is equal to minus 2, which is equal to g of x into x minus 2. What we have to find out? G of x. So we have to take it separate. That's why I am going to take it on the divide form on the left hand side. X cube minus 3x square plus 3x minus 2 divided by x minus 2, which is equal to g of x. It means we can easily calculate g of x if we divide by this polynomial. So this becomes the division form of your quotient. Please do. We have to divide x cube minus 3x square plus 3 into x minus 2 divided by x minus 2. Our first term is x cube. It means we have to divide by first. We got x square. So our first term is x square. Multiply x square into x, x cube. X square into minus 2, minus 2x square. Change the sign, negative, positive. This will be cancelled. Negative, positive, it gives us minus x square plus 3x minus 2. Now our first term is minus x square. Divide form is same. What we will got? Minus x. Now multiply it with minus x. Minus x into x, we got minus x square. Minus x into 2, minus 2x. Now change the sign, positive, positive. They are cancelled. 2x plus 3x, which is equal to 5x minus 2. Now our first term is 5x and this first term is x. Cancel out with x, we got 5. Now we have to multiply it with 5. 5 into x, because 5x 5 into minus 2 minus 10. Change the sign, negative positive, they are cancelled. Positive 10 minus 2, we got positive 8. Please make a note first. Sorry, we are doing second step all wrong, because minus x into minus x, we got minus x square, and minus x into minus 2, we got plus 2x, and this sign is negative. So I am writing here negative. So this is your negative x into minus 2, we get positive 2x. Now change the sign, positive, negative, they are cancelled. 3x, this is 2x, we got x, and this one is minus 2. Now our first term is here x, and we have to divide by x, it means we got 1. 1 into x, x, 1 into minus 2, minus, it means cancelled. And this is g of x is our x square minus x plus 1. This is your final answer. So make a note first. Now I am going to take our next and your last question. This is basically your conceptual based question, and you have to take some assumption, and you have to make imagination. After that you can do this question, and you have to take, you can take so many examples. I am choosing one example of each type of question. Please read the statement, give example. It means we have to take some examples of P, this polynomial which satisfies the division algorithm. Division algorithm means we have to satisfy the Euclid algorithm division method. We have first question is, what it say? It say degree of the polynomial, it means we are talking about degree of P of x is equal to degree of Q of x, should be equal. Give an example. Please make note of this. We have to make the degree of this and degree of Q of x. We have to make degree same. Firstly, you have to note that after multiplying g of x into q of x, and we have, then we add r of x, we get a polynomial which is same as degree of the g of x. So what you have to take, suppose if I am degree of a polynomial is 1.